this is what I want to do. The fact that it's all up in the air right now, and I don't know if I will be able to fulfill all of this, kind of has me stressed out. Annabelle is down for a nap, which literally, I swear she's sleeping half of the day still, which is fine. It works for me. If she needs to sleep, she's gonna sleep, and it's all good. But I finally figured out my college schedule yesterday. It was basically all done, and then I decided that I wanted to complicate my life some more. So I did, and it took quite a bit of work, to be completely honest. And I'm trying to find, let's see, I think I have a picture of my schedule, but I just wanted to share my schedule with you guys so you kind of know the craziness that my life is about to be in a couple weeks. So, Monday, Wednesday, Friday, starting at 6 a.m., I have PT. If you don't know what PT is, it's physical training, kind of like military term for working out, I guess. Let's see. Then, so that's Monday, Wednesday, Friday from 6 a.m. to 7:30 a.m. Then Monday, I have an accounting class from 9:10 to 10 a.m. Anthropology, which is pretty similar to sociology, I believe. It's from 10:20 to 11:10. And then I have Math 121, which is finite math with calculus, which I need for my business degree. And that's from 12:40 to 1:30 p.m. So that's Monday. Tuesday, the only class that I have is English, and that's from 9:35 to 10:50. Wednesday, again, I have PT at 6 o'clock until 7:30, and so my Monday, Wednesday, Friday schedule are all the same. So I have accounting, and then I have anthropology, and then I have math. Then Thursday, I have MS 101, which I believe that's like military science basics. Pretty much like intro to military science, something similar to that, probably not exactly that, but that's from 10 to 10:50, and then I have my math class on Thursday as well from 12:40 to 1:30, and then from 4 to 6 p.m. I have military lead lab, which I don't really know how to explain to y'all, but if you're in ROTC, you should know what that is. I've never been in it before. I just know that that's one of the requirements, so that's what they put me in. I don't know what it all entails. And then Friday, I have the same schedule as Monday and Wednesday. So that is what my college schedule is going to look like. I really tried to get all my classes like back to back, because then afterwards I could just come home and do homework, and I'd be around Annabelle, so I could still watch her, but not, like, necessarily be completely, like, in charge of her at the time, because, as I've probably said, my mom said that she is willing to watch Annabelle when I am busy with classes and also with homework, so I would have really liked to have more of my classes back-to-back, but it doesn't always work out that way. Even with my schedule that I had before, it wasn't really that way. I had, like, an hour and a half, or I think it was, like, an hour and 20 minutes between classes Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, like, between my second and third class. And, you know, things just don't always work out the way you want them to. But with that, if you're wondering why I am in PT and other military classes, I am going to be taking Army ROTC classes in hopes that I will be able to get into the ROTC program and then commission, well, contract first, and then commission after I graduate as an Army officer. The only problem with that is in the military, you are not allowed to be a single parent with custody of your child. And I don't really know how much leeway they have on that, because in most situations that does make sense that the sole caretaker of a child should not be able to be in the military. And legally, I am my daughter's sole caretaker. The reality of the situation is I have a lot of support and a lot of help from other people. And it's not like I'm just pawning my daughter off on other people to try to do what I want to do. But it is more that I personally feel like I have a calling to be in the military. Hence why when I was a senior in high school, I enlisted in the Minnesota National Guard. So not being able to do that after I got pregnant was really, really difficult for me. And every time I would see someone in uniform or hear about someone doing all these things, I'd be like, I don't know why, but I felt bad. Not necessarily for myself, but I felt guilty that I wasn't fulfilling, like, the obligations that I had said that I would. So when I enlisted in the National Guard, I had an 8-year contract with the Army National Guard. And I believe the last 2 years I'd be in the reserves, which is like inactive ready reserves. If I don't know how to explain everything, to be honest. But all that information kind of comes to you as you go. And I didn't make it that far because I did get pregnant, and that is my fault. That was my doing. But still, I feel like I have a calling to be in the military, to serve the country. And it's not a for sure thing. It's not going to be 100% possible necessarily. But if I can do anything to make that happen for myself and for my daughter, then that's what I'm going to do. So, there is a possibility that I can get a waiver that will basically allow me to go through the program just like anyone else would, with cadre and commanders knowing that I will be able to fulfill all my military duties. So I'm taking the ROTC classes this year. If I do well, if I make it to all the classes, if I do well on my PT tests, all that, there is a much better chance that I will be able to get a waiver. And in that case, I will contract into ROTC. I will commission as a lieutenant in the Army, and I will basically be doing everything that I feel like I need to do. And some people might not agree with that. That is fine. That is your choice, your personal beliefs. I went back and forth on it for a while, and I realized that I had to convince myself for so long that it was a bad idea, for the sake of other people's feelings and other people's take on it, and that doesn't really help me in the long run. So this is what I want to do. The fact that it's all up in the air right now and I don't know if I will be able to fulfill all of this kind of has me stressed out because basically I'm taking three classes that end up being, what, around 10 hours every week total. And I'm not, like, if I can't go through with ROTC, then I'm thankful for the experience, but it is kind of a waste of time because I, like, yes, doing PT will keep me in shape and it'll help me that way, but beyond that, there's not very many things that I'd be doing that would help me beyond being in the military, if that makes sense. So I'm just taking a shot in the dark with this. I am hoping for the best, but I'm not guaranteeing anything. I'm trying not to get my hopes up, even though that is really difficult, but this is just the situation right now, and I guess we will see how it goes.